Welcome to the October KLS meeting, convening located here at UTM Martin. You're all lucky enough to be here for our Ken Devo show. We're going to have a lot of exciting things here happening. We're a bunch of different schools. We have Murray, over there. Give a round of applause.
Anybody not like that place? This drink's for you. All right, so what we're going to do is in this vial, we have potassium chlorate. And pour it into a test tube.
And what Patrick's about to do is heat it up to what we call a molten state, like a liquid. Which this might take a few minutes.
So, what are gummy bears made of? Sugar? Alright. Sugar and potassium chloride don't like each other very much. And I'm kind of like the little guy in the back. I don't really like gummy bears. So what we're going to do today is called death of a gummy bear. We're going to show you what happens when the sugar or gummy bear meets potassium chloride. What we're doing right now is heating potassium chlorate to a molten state so that it's liquid. Right now it's solid. Wouldn't do much if you put the gummy bear in there.
Thank you.
Now I've got calcium carbide. So when the two react, I'm going to get acetylene. And then I'm going to get photoelectric.
Back and forth between two chemicals, this kind of an oscillating reaction.
and Louise. And an awesome funnel of black carbon.
Yeah. Today, we're going to show you a demonstration called gas bubble or bubbles.
I'm going to put two big chunks of dry ice into this bowl.
Mm-hmm.
most easily liquids off the carbon, staying off the carbon. So we put that on top of the sand and make it again. Then those particles, sand particles, get some of the hydrophobic qualities that the Scotch guard has. So first demonstrate kind of just dumps the sand, right? And you see water.
It just sinks straight to the bottom.
So
it sinks right from the bottom there. Now with magic sand, if you add just a little bit of sand, it won't sink at all. It'll stay on top of the water, which is what's happening. And that'll even happen for quite a while, until you get enough weight to push it down. So that's about half a testing with magic sand there. But if you add enough at one time, it will sink into the water, but still retain its shape. It'll stay dry.
So that doesn't look anything like sand here, because it's got the hydrophobic coating, and so the water, the sand, or the pellets, the sand contracts itself into the shape.
Without making too much of a mess, if you were to take that back out of the water, it would still be just as dry as this bag is. And this is really dry.
Okay. The next.
No. So right here, we have ferrofluid. It is a magnetic liquid. So what we're going to do is we're going to pour some of it out and walk it around. It's hard to see from up here. So, here you go. Well, maybe we can use a projector. So anyways, this is ferric fluid. How we made it is we take ferric chloride and ferrous chloride, and those are both aqueous solutions, and you put them together, and then you get, there's your magnetic iron. And then from there, you add just some good old household ammonia, or ammonium hydroxide, and that makes it, yeah. Anyways, yeah, so you add your ammonia, and then you add some, oleic acid for the, you add oleic acid, and then you put in some kerosene, and we let it sit overnight, and it's separated. So you decant the kerosene is there as a
thank you.
takes ferric fluid.
Hey guys, I'm Brooklyn, and this is Spencer.
Hey.
We are going to celebrate this election year by being very patriotic. So we've got a patriotic dinner, being very simple. So in this first one, we're going to put some potassium thiocyanate. And in the second one, we're going to put silver nitrate. And in the third, we're going to put potassium ferrocyanide.
Give a complex ion reaction, and you're going to see these solutions actually change colors.
Most concentrated solution of bacteria, so it should
there's no color, you know that there are still bacteria from them that have on the top.
I It's just like really loud.
What?
Deprotonating water makes the base, and then the nickel drops out of solution as a, it's
soluble peroxide is still white component. Feel free to ooh and ah at any moment.
Gilbert told his really bad chemistry joke, there was no reaction. This is a Lincoln replacement reaction. Add a turn a little bit of
reddish color. Mine was again more.
So this is just showing the differences between the three. We've got the regular, we have the one with the calcium thiocyanate added, and then the one with ammonia
added. Which one bitch?
Because the sodium iodide has iodine
when you add I then to the I3 minus this form, and I3 minus this color, which is the purplish green. Now I'm about to add bleach chloride to sodium chloride. And as you can see, nothing happens because we have chlorine already in solution and we're adding more chlorine, so nothing really happens. So no change. This one is sodium bromide. And as I add bleach, I don't know if you guys can see clearly, but there is a yellowish layer forming at the top, which is the aqueous, and that is the bromine in the aqueous layer. What happened was, when I added Clorox, the sodium bromide broke and sodium chlorine formed. That's sodium chloride. And bromine is soluble in the aqueous layer, which is giving off that yellowish color you're seeing. And then the last one, I'm going to add it to sodium iodide. This one, when I added Clorox, the sodium iodide broke and I formed sodium chloride. And the iodine changed to iodine and went into the organic layer, which is that pink color at the bottom that you're seeing. And at the top is the sodium chloride.
Finally, we're going to be adding bromine water for our solution of sodium chloride.
As you can see,
there's still a little bit of yellow left up here in the aqueous layer. And you might be wondering, well, I understand that chlorine is more electronegative than bromine and should be able to replace it. Why isn't it? Well, chlorine is in fact a replacement, but bromine is more soluble in the aqueous medium than it is in organic, so it doesn't want to move down into the organic layer and change its color. Next, we add our bromine solution to our sodium bromide. Again, we have the simple layer of bromine. It's not moving down to the organic, but it's still more soluble than water. And finally, where it should be most reactive, with the sodium iodide solution. Can you hear it go? You can see that iodine has been in fact replaced on the complex in the aqueous layer from the organic layer and moved from the aqueous layer and moved down into the organic layer, giving you its characteristic pinkish purple color.
Stand up. So, and you're lucky because that's a bad joke. Sure. Who wants to guess what's in here?
Cranberry juice.
Wine.
Liquid.
Okay, so we're gonna get this. So it's water and luminol. Also here we have a dye agent called Erlogan B. So if all goes according to plan, we're going to see something very different. Actually,
I thank you guys for having us here at the Tulsa Right National Chemistry Week. In light of Halloween, Nicole and I, my name's Amanda, we're going to present to you what we think to do as Google. Okay, what I have here is some dry ice. I'm going to put it in some warm water. I'm going to place the, first I'm going to put some soapy water solution on the end. I'm going to place the lid on top of the jar, and the jar is okay, what happens is the dry ice is a solid form of carbon dioxide. When I place it in the jar and seal the lid on, it forces the carbon dioxide sublimes first, and it forces the carbon dioxide gas through the tube, and it's enclosed in soapy film. So just a fun Halloween trick. Because the oil and dirt on your hands can cause the bubble, so you're actually these aren't like right out of the package gloves. We actually have used these a couple of times, so it may actually work better if you just use like just straight up package clean fabric. But they still work pretty well. We actually performed this experiment for our school yesterday, and we actually did a little skit, and they wouldn't bounce as much. So, I don't know, it's working good today, but which is good. So that ends, that's Boo Bubbles. Thank you.
My experiment is involves 4 grams of sodium polyacrylate. Sodium polyacrylate is very water absorbent, capable of absorbing several hundred times its weight in water. So absorbent that with just that pouring 800 milliliters of water into 4 grams of sodium polyacrylate produces this.
Small nucleation site in crystallizes. So here's our meat.
So they're going to look pretty nice. And with that, I bid you all adieu.